Ignorance.
Ignorance.
The fact that funding for EPA has been reduced so much is really a major, major setback to humanity.
Climate change.
Climate change. I'm a little biased because that's what I work on, but climate change.
If we don't protect what resources we have, then our children will have nothing left.
Why am I marching? Well, we really need to be putting more money into research and STEM education.
I'm marching for the future of research because, you know, it all comes down to funding.
We all know that the current administration in particular has eroded support for science. They intend to cut funding for the NIH in particular and many other scientific agencies. This is a terribly bad idea.
I'm marching today because of Trump's ignorance in the facts of, in the fact that science is a fact.
I'm appalled by the current political climate that denigrates the significance of science.
I just wanted to support that really everything we do in the lab, it's real, producing real data. I'm very disappointed when someone look at the data, they don't believe it, they say this is fake.
I think there's a disturbing amount of comfort with alternative facts.
We're here for her, Mother Earth.
That God calls us to care for creation. Humans have been causing climate change, which is destroying our planets and the future generations, and we have to act now. And this administration needs to understand that and help find a solution.
All of the organisms that support us, I'm here to support them.
There needs to be very strong awareness in our own public for science. And I hope that this march is, of course, a start, but this is a campaign for public awareness.
I hope it brings to light the importance of trusting people who have spent years and years gaining an education.
Political decisions are driven by facts, by science.
It's not about Democrats and Republicans. It's about people who understand that science pushes back the limits of ignorance and those who believe otherwise.
We're not going to be passive, that we're going to play an active role in ensuring that we protect the environment and that we want to dial back our carbon footprint. This work was made.
Hopefully science will be in the vein of these two great men, be improving humankind.
In the mid-90s, the biggest killer of young adults in this country was HIV and AIDS. Now very few people in our country die of HIV and AIDS. The fight is not over, though. There are many people dying in other countries. We really need a vaccine.
How can we provide the best care with optimal cost? That's something that is, I think, a challenge, not just for this country, but globally.
We cannot improve health if we don't have good access to good data. And we don't have good access to data because we don't have a single-payer system and we don't have a data together of all people.
Immuno-oncology, this is a very hot issue. A lot of progress made in the past several years, so if we just push a little bit harder, we can achieve it very shortly.
I think that we'll have a lot more information about the regulation of genes.
There's this precision medicine initiative where you really try to target treatment to the specific characteristics of the patient, and we have the data to do all these things, but we can't pursue this research if, you know, I have my science, public data for public good. We can pursue this research if we get our funding sources like NIH cut.
We hope that it can cross borders so that people can see that we're all one.
We're looking to translate scientific evidence to large scale to improve the health of people around the world. We know what to do, and it's figuring out how to do it and reach scale.
A lot of that depends on our current climate because we can't fund ourselves. And so we need funding from the federal government, and we need funding from foundations in the private sector.